Thank you very much for having me here to speak about BIM in general and OpenBIM in particular. And, well, what an amazing project we already saw. So I will take you a little bit on a journey why OpenBIM works. And to start with, to begin with, let me tell you a little bit about who I am. Well, I run a very small company in the Netherlands. It's called BIM Captain. And Graphisoft is my biggest client, so to say. I work 99.9% at this moment for Graphisoft as their OpenBIM program manager. And I'm heavily involved in Building Smart, which I will explain a little bit more. I'm a certified BIM supporter consultant, and I will speak a little bit about that as well. And for your information, I was educated as a civil engineer, but I have a crush for architecture. And I've worked with many software in the past. And, well, I started in 91, age 23, with AutoCAD. And, well, here you can see the road that I walked. So, I'm from the Netherlands. And you all know the Netherlands. But did you know that gin, you know, the British liquor, was invented in the Netherlands, and it's called Genever, and that we still have over 1,000 windmills running to keep our feet dry. 70% of the Netherlands is built below sea level. And of course, you know that Amsterdam is the capital of the Netherlands, and all of you are going there, but I will invite you to come to my city, which is called Rotterdam. And Rotterdam is really amazing. Well, if you are there, visit me, please. This is the view from my home. Not all at the same time, but you're always welcome in my place. So I work with Graphisoft. And Graphisoft is located in Budapest. So I work a lot from home, I travel a lot, and this is our office in Budapest. And Graphisoft, as you probably know, is a Nemetschek company. And Nemetschek, I want to really speak a little bit about Nemetschek, is a group of industry-leading companies. Here you can see them on the bottom. You see a lot of companies that you're probably familiar with, Elplan, De Roofers maybe, Solibri, a lot of you are using that, and of course, Graphisoft. And in our DNA is open. So the philosophy of Nemetschek, as you can read here, is that we are open and we declare our support of OpenBIM. So it's not something fancy, it's not a marketing topic. No, we really believe in the essence of OpenBIM. And then another look again at Graphisoft. Well, we started with BIM since the very beginning. So since 1980, when Gábor Bajor founded the company, and he invented in 1984 the virtual building concept. In that time, we didn't spoke about BIM yet. And since 1995, we joined Building Smart, which was called different at that time. In 2007, the acquisition of Nemetschek by Nemetschek, and in 2012, together with Tekla and some other software vendors, we launched the OpenBIM program. And now I hear you think, well, I did it. Is OpenBIM really different from BIM? Well, I don't know what you do when you want to know the answer to a question, but I know what I do because I call my wisest uncle. And then, well, he didn't know it, for sure. And then what you do next is you call a friend or you Google it. Well, so I called a friend. And he explained to me.
So OpenBIM works because it gives everyone in the supply chain an opportunity to pick their tool of choice to essentially deliver an output or a deliverable for a client. If we're all stuck using the same tool, you won't actually get the right output because you don't build a building with just a screwdriver. You use a whole series of different tools to build a building. Why should it be any different with the software that we use?
You can't build a house with only a screwdriver. So you need a collection of tools. So why should that be different in the design process? Nathan Hildebrand, he's a brilliant speaker, and you should really get in touch with him. The third thing I did is I Googled OpenBIM, and then I ended up with Building Smart. And I'm involved in Building Smart, and I tell you a little bit what Building Smart is. Building Smart wants to enable a clear line of sight across all information. So we borrowed this slide from Digitally Built Britain, and here you can see the intention of delivering both the information feed forward and the information loop backwards. And there are a lot of OpenBIM proponents at this moment. The Economic World Forum is one of them, and they quoted recently that what the industry needs is big and open BIM, which integrates the entire value chain and is characterized by full interoperability of software and open access to it. So that was coming from the World Economic Forum, and they introduced this action plan, and in that action plan, Building Smart was awarded for the very important work what they are doing. And I'm really proud to be one of those people involved in Building Smart. For your information, I represent the whole Nemetschek group in some of the Building Smart technical committees as well. So really important. So what Building Smart is, it's the home of the OpenBIM. There it is. It's open, it's neutral, so there is a lot of software vendors as well. They don't have any preferred software vendors contributing, and it's non-for-profit. I think that's really important. So the development of open standards in a non-for-profit way. And speaking about those open standards, there are five of them coming from Building Smart. And we heard IFC already, which is the data structure of OpenBIM. We have, so this is the most complex slide of my whole presentation. We have IDM, which stands for Information Delivery Manuals, which speaks about the processes. We have the Building Collaboration Format, or the BIM Collaboration Format, which is BCF to exchange issues. And then we are working all with data dictionaries, so that's the IFD and the Building Smart Data Dictionary. And MVD stands for Model View Definition, and a Model View Definition is a subset, well, you can remember it like that, a subset of IFC for a specific goal. I brought you some examples why OpenBIM works, and this is a very nice one I brought. I think this one is lagging. I don't know why. Okay. So this is the Naples Central Station by Minucci Associati. And they did a 380 gigabyte point cloud to begin with. And their goal of this BIM project was asset management of 12,500 components, including all safety and security systems. It's 400,000 square meters. It consists of four terminals, shops, and other services. And what you see here is a combined point cloud and Archicad software. And one of the owners and founders of the company, I asked him the same question. Why does OpenBIM work?
OpenBIM works because it's the only way to share the information. No one program is better than another one. Of course, there is some program that is stronger in something, but you need to use all the program, all the system, and you'll never know what will happen tomorrow. You have to be free from the companies. That's it.
So, you will never know what will happen tomorrow. And we just heard that there are software vendors that are changing their system, and he said, we want to be free from the companies, and then he means us, you know, the software companies. So, invest in OpenBIM, and he think that that's a really good idea. So the major challenge of OpenBIM is, well, we all know that if we that we worked all in one CAD system, and we could easily exchange information with each other. And the major challenge of OpenBIM is not combining all that information. It's really about combining all those different data structures as well. So there is no one BIM data format. So I think OpenBIM isn't about file formats or it's about collaboration. It's about a mindset. By the way, this example is coming from Enzyme, and later we will have one of the architects of Enzyme on stage to maybe present this. I don't know what he's really speaking about. So I think that in the end we should combine all that information and aggregate the information that we need. Sorry for not being so. That it's not working. So we heard about the 2020 strategy of Poland. There is a 2025 strategy in the UK as well, and maybe you've heard about it. They are two very important targets to reach. One is that they want to build 50% quicker in 2025, and 33%, so one third cheaper, which is really something. It's okay now? Okay, it's okay. Okay. So, and can you imagine if the guys in the UK are still having those targets and they are trying to reach it, what you can achieve, considering they are way ahead? And one thing really important there is that BIM supporters did a survey that international organization of consultants I told you about. They did a survey, and one of the results of that survey was that there's a 71% likelihood that if you think about your BIM goals, if you define your BIM goals, your targets, then you have a 70% likelihood that you use OpenBIM standards, and the other way around as well. So if you use OpenBIM standards, you probably have thought about your goals. And thinking about those goals, it's really important to describe them. And I think you all need to work with a BIM execution plan. So if you are going to implement BIM and OpenBIM, work with a BIM execution plan. So there are deadlines, the stakeholders, the data environment, we're speaking about exchange. And if you don't know how to produce one, because those are thorough documents, maybe you can come to the website of BIM supporters and you do the BIM execution plan generator with your team. Just go there, click through, and you see what agreements you should make and describe in the BIM execution plan. I brought another nice example, a real life example from an OpenBIM project. It's an amazing project. It's the Center for Rhythmic Gymnastics in Moscow. And Pride is the company that developed this in a very special way, because they used a lot of software. And this is a simplified version of their scheme of software that they were using. But here you can see many software used. And this is the outcome of all that BIM data in a very early phase. So they created this movie from, I don't know, the first couple of weeks experimenting with BIM. And the nice thing is that they didn't only produce this movie, but they gave the complete model in a very early phase to the owner, to the client. And they were able to move through the BIM with their finger just on an iPad, as you can see here. So they could really feel what the interaction was all about. And that owner, that client, could see easily all those various examples of the design, which is very impressive. And how did they do it? They did it because they didn't use only one software. They used, in this example, they used Rhino Grasshopper together with Archicad. And they had sliders, as you can see here, algorithmic sliders, which controlled the situation of the roof. So they could easily make various designs. That was made with Rhino Grasshopper. They used Alplan, and they used Sapphire and Lyra. So you cannot use only one kind of software. The people involved in this project were not picked because they were working with the same software. They were picked, handpicked, because they did their job the best. So that Lyra software is for numeric analysis of a structure. They used Tekla, and I've been working quite a lot with Tekla, and probably you know that with Tekla you cannot do real good architecture, but you can do amazing steel structure. So it's very, very nice to work together with them. And even Autodesk Revit and later Magicad was used in this project. They used Solibri Model Checker. And in the end, they created all these outputs, all these images and drawings from the aggregated model, from all the aspect models that you can see here, all the models combined. So this is really a very good example of collaboration and of OpenBIM. And to conclude this project,
OpenBIM works because everybody can use his full potential without relying on a software.
Well, that went very quick. That's Arno de Rijst, and he's coming from Sweden. He says that everybody can use their full potential regardless of their BIM software. But how do you know what your full potential is? That's really something, eh? And do you need to reach your full potential? I don't think it's always necessary to walk on your toes. But there are some measuring tools available on the market. For instance, you can go again to that BIM supporter website and you can do a BIM quick scan. And you can hire a consultant to do that big scan, to do that BIM quick scan with you. Maybe you want to be one of those consultants. Well, reach out to the guys. And what they did is they created this BIM ladder. And if you answer questions, then you find out where you are on that ladder. And you can benchmark yourself with peers in another country or another company. So you know what your real potential is and you know what potential you need to really collaborate. I was involved in creating that, and there was another guy, a BIM strategist, who has something to say
why
to
open
as well.
BIM works.
Open BIM works so that everybody can use their own software to analyze their own added value for the project, so that they can and that they can recycle the information. So somebody else made some makes some information for me, and I can recycle it in my process. So it saves a lot of time and money.
It saves a lot of time and money, which is very important. And he says, well, so one of the benefits is that everybody can use their own software. Use the other information in your own process. That is really important. And well, but I will come back to the saves a lot of time and money because, okay, I'm from Holland, he's from Holland. In Holland, we are a little picky sometimes. And if we can, well, make money, no one has to explain why we have to use it if we can make some money with it. So why OpenBIM works in the Netherlands is because we have real business cases that people can make money in using OpenBIM. And it's a bottom-up approach. So we just saw that all around the world, there's a mandate coming from the government to use with OpenBIM. And I really endorse that. It's being used in governmental projects, but in the private sector, it's not common to do it. So then you have to work with your project teams, and you have to convince the owner that OpenBIM is the good way to work. And if you have that OpenBIM approach, and you can really prove that you can make money with it, and it's on the long time very efficient for the owner as well. It's a really good thing. And well, in Holland, we came with this idea to keep IFC simple stupid, because IFC is sometimes really, really complex. It doesn't work. It's slow. You know all those. Everybody have heard about it. But if you know something else, I think, and maybe you do too as well, that BIM is a demand-driven process. So we don't just go export an IFC and we share it. No, we ask the others what they need and we supply them with the best kind of information so they can do the job better. So, and therefore, we need those agreements in that information delivery manual that I spoke about. And we have this two-pager, two A4s, with basic agreements, like how do we name things? Where is the insertion point of your model? So the 000, so that you don't have the windows floating above your building. How do we name the stories, you know, those kind of things, and use the correct entities. So you can easily draw a beam, extract the beam, and call that a wall. But if you export it, it's still a beam when it comes to the properties of objects. And we have that translated now into many languages. So it started in Dutch, English, German, Spanish, French, Portuguese, Estonian and Swedish. We are working on a Japanese version now and a Ukraine version. And I encourage you to translate it or to adopt it. And if you want to know more, then I can supply you with the people to contact. I still have one case to present to you. It's a Dutch case. A Dutch Why OpenBIM Work movie, and it's a little bit longer. So I hope you can join this.
Mm-hmm.
This is a residential project of the construction of 55 villas in a beautiful place in Amersfoort. The houses are built in practically a forest, but really close to the center of the city, so it's a really fine location.
Well, it are 55 houses, but they are all custom made for each owner. So essentially, every house is different.
The architect is Mulliners & Mulliners from Amsterdam. It's a classical, authentic style. We started building the project in 2018, and the year of completion is 2019.
We were really challenged by the customization of each resident, and we had to figure out a way to do it most efficiently.
So we had to create a very specific workflow in Archicad to make sure all generic elements are used once, so we don't have to model things twice.
But we use Archicad for making our architectural models, and we use Solibri Model Checker for the internal model checking. And besides that, co-makers used Revit, Allplan, Tekla.
The partners are selected in an early phase of the design, so they can give their feedback on the initial design.
For example, we used IFC to communicate the models, but we also used BCF to communicate the issues.
Every other week, we have partner meetings at Van Ommen en de Groot, where we use a big screen to project all the IFCs from all the partners.
We work with different suppliers of concrete. So we have our elements drawn in India. They draw in Allplan. And we have some suppliers in Holland for the floors. So they also draw in different systems, and they have different production locations. And all together, we have to make it in the Casco with Fitch.
I use the models for the quantities, exact quantities. So I don't need the drawing for the quantity takeoff.
For now, in the modeling, we make all our disciplines. And when it's fit, it's finished, then we must put all that information in our firm. And to make our machinery, we must understand the data, and that's the biggest challenge.
There are like 10 to 15 partners using these open BIM models, but in the end, there are more than 50 disciplines depending on the information delivered from these models.
We used prefab elements from concrete and timber. Because we have coordinated, we have less problems.
If the base model is right for elements, we can just adjust them in our system and fix them up with some detailed things we need for our production, like lifting bolts for the crane or there's some things.
In the end, we didn't have any problems on site.
In the future, BIM will be a normal way of working together, and I think the term BIM will disappear.
Open BIM works because it allows me to learn from the partners involved in the processes. And I can take this, what I've learned, into my own work, which makes it even more fun to do.
Open BIM really works because it forces all the partners to really work together, and that results in a smooth process and eventually a very good construction of the project.
The advantage of Open BIM is that you have less mistakes and you have to improvise less. Consequently, everything fits and it costs less. And I'm really glad to see that.
The last guy, he is the owner. So consequently, it costs less, and I'm glad to see that. And he said some important things as well, that he thinks that the term BIM will disappear. That's just a normal way of working. And I think this is a really good example why to use Open BIM. And okay, there we go. I'm asking you, in which direction do you want the industry to go, this construction industry? Because you know, with a flock of birds, that the birds in flying in the middle have no idea where they're going. The steering is coming from the sides, so the direction is coming from the sides, and not from the center, not from the leader. It's coming from the sides. If you want to get noticed and you want to make an impact, you need to stand up from the crowd. And if you believe like I do, that open BIM is the direction to go, please direct into that direction, or else please stay in that center. Thank you very much. Thank you.